Hello all, welcome to a focus session on next generation data synchronization experience in Telugu.ERP 9 Series A Release 5.0. Let us see the agenda, business requirement, product walkthrough, summary, and FAQs. Let us see the business requirement, seamless exchange of information across multiple locations. In today's information-driven business scenario, being connected on business locations for exchange of information is very essential. As such, every businessman would want to ensure that there's a simple, secure, and reliable way to consolidate and disseminate information across locations. This would help him to monitor, react, and make effective decisions in the competitive environment. Exchange information without being connected. Multiple location synchronization to one have several performance issues. Also, it is practically not always possible for both the systems to be online at the same time. As such, it is a common business requirement to have such advanced capability of seamless sharing of data across locations, and that too without being simultaneously connected. Centrally managed masters. In order to prevent duplication of masters, every businessman would want to ensure that masters are created by a few people and at one or more decided locations. Let us see how Release 5.0 addresses all these requirements and makes data synchronization simple. Let us take up a scenario. Take the case of a growing international business. The company has its head office in Bangalore and branch offices are located in other states and countries. Now, transactions of sales, purchases, payments, and inventory are being constantly recorded across branches and consolidation of all this at the head office level. This is a very common practice. With branches located in different places and even across geographical boundaries and different time zones, the businessman would need to take so much trouble in aligning schedules of all these offices to synchronize business data. Further, simultaneously connected systems for synchronization leads to performance issues with people waiting in queue. But now, with on-demand synchronization, which is a feature of Telugu.ERP 9 Release 5.0, this trouble is now over. You can now enjoy multiple point synchronization effectively and seamlessly, and that too without being connected at the same time. So let us see how. Release 5.0 brings along with its capability of on-demand synchronization. That is, synchronization across two or more instances of Tally, even if they are not connected to internet at the same time. Now this is possible because Tally.net now acts as a store and forward server. Let us take up a scenario where user X pushes the data to user Y. The data gets stored in Tally.net. Currently, user Y is not connected to Tally.net, but once he is online, he connects to Tally.net server and he pulls any data which is available on Tally.net for him. As a result, there is absolutely no dependency on the other user's connectivity status, and also there is no requirement of following any strict schedules. This gives tremendous convenience to all users. This gives also another major benefit, that is, multiple users or branches can synchronize without any performance hurdles, because now it is not necessary to synchronize at the same time. Let us see this in action with Tally.erp 9 release 5.
For demo purpose, we have taken two instances of Tally. One, Tally Bangalore, and another, Tally Mumbai. Tally Mumbai is a branch office which we are resembling over here with black and white Tally, and Tally Bangalore, which is the head office, okay, which is seen in color. So let us see how we do the setup and how this on-demand synchronization works. So as we have created these two companies, let us create a client role. So from the gateway of Tally, we go to import of data. We do not see synchronization option over here. So let us configure that by pressing F12. We say here advanced configuration and select both. So as we have enabled in F12, now we get the option over here, import of data, synchronization, we create a client rule. Okay, currently we name for the transaction, name of the rule, sync on demand. This is the new option, use on demand synchronization. This we need to make it as yes, and this is possible only through Tally.net server. Let us write the name of the server account ID. Name on the other side of the branch. Both the ways. And save it. Now we have Mumbai company over here, but we are not connecting to Tally.net server. So let's synchronize the rule from head office side by pressing OOO. This is initial handshake which we are doing. We have sent the rule from Tally Bangalore to Tally Mumbai. Now Tally Mumbai gets connected to TallyNet server by pressing OOO and sees if there is any message for this company. Tally Mumbai has read the message which was there on the Tally.net server sent from Tally Bangalore. So now from Tally Mumbai, let's activate the rule. Import of data, synchronize, server rule, activate. So here we get that rule which is sent from Tally Bangalore. So here we activate the rule and save it. And after doing this, we once again confirm to Tally Bangalore that we have activated the rule at our place. So we do synchronize from here by pressing OOO. Here we have completed the initial handshake between the two companies, between the two locations. Now let us pass few transactions in Tally Bangalore office. Let us pass few sales entries. ABC Enterprise, Sundry Data, Sales, 40,000, and Saved. XYZ Traders. and sale. Okay, so we have passed to sales entry in the Bangalore. Okay, and now we want to send this two entries to Mumbai office. However, currently Mumbai company is not connected to Tally.net server, but still from Bangalore I can send the transactions by pressing OOO. As we have said in the presentation, that now Tally.net server acts as a store and forward server. So the data sent from this company Tally Bangalore is residing on Tally.net server. Whenever the Tally Mumbai company connects to Tally.net server, it will receive its data from Tally.net server. So let us see that what happens when Tally Mumbai connects to Tally.net server by pressing OOO. As we see, even though Tally Mumbai office was not connected at the same time when Tally Bangalore had sent the data, so still the stored data on the Tally.net server has received to Tally Mumbai. Now let's confirm the transactions. Yes, we are able to see in Tally Mumbai the two transactions which were sent from Tally Bangalore. Both the instances, both the companies were not connected at the same time. Still, they were able to exchange the data seamlessly. This is the feature of 5.0 which will help the users to a great extent. As you saw in the demo, creating the synchronized rule and synchronizing data was so simple. You can get started in minutes. For data synchronization to happen, two systems need not connect at the same time. A user can synchronize at his own preferred time. Whenever the other user comes online, he will get the synchronized data. There is no dependency on each other's connectivity status. Also, it provides flexibility and convenience for multiple point synchronization. Definitely, there won't be any performance issues with this on-demand synchronization. This gives relief to thousands of Tally users who use Tally synchronization. Scenario 2. Now, let us take up another prominent feature of next generation data synchronization, that is master data synchronization. Release 5.0 brings along with its robust mechanism of master data synchronization so as to ensure consistency and uniformity in the masters maintained in both the client and server systems. This will avoid the creation of multiple ledger accounts for the same account head or party and make reporting, tax compliance and other controls extremely efficient and easy. Let us see how efficiently and seamlessly the consistent propagation of masters is handled in Tally release 5.0. Now let us see how master data synchronization works in Tally.net release 5.0. So for instance, what we have done is we have taken Tally head office, which is there in color, and Tally branch office, which is in black and white. So what we'll do, we'll create a rule in Tally branch for masters. Import of data, synchronization, client rule, create. We are creating rule for masters. So we'll select type over here as masters, create a rule over here, sync masters. Use on-demand synchronization, sync via Tally.net server. Tally head office, and here since the data, the masters will be flown from server to client or from head office to branch office, we will select over here as receive data and save this. So after creating
the master client rule, we need to send it to the head office. So let us send that by pressing OOO. So after sending the client rule from branch office, let us activate that on the head office side. But for that, we need to connect to Telugu.net server. From Telugu.net server, we get the rule which was created in the branch office. Now this rule we are setting, or this configuration we are doing, so that head office creates masters, they have the control over the masters, and they send the data to the branch office. So always the masters would be created in head office and they will be flown to the branch office. So since we are seeing over here, it has synchronized with the Telugu.net server, we need to activate the rule. So we go into import of data synchronize, in server rule, we activate, yes, we got this rule and we are activating this rule from here. Save. So after activating the rule from here, we synchronize the data to confirm the handshake. So after handshake, let us create some masters at the head office level. Tally silver. Tally gold. Tally currency. So we have created these masters and let us send these masters to the branch office. So for that, we synchronize from here by pressing OOO. But for synchronization, we have also provided a shortcut. Okay, here this is option Alt O on the gateway of Tally. So by clicking on this also, we can synchronize the data. So this we are doing offline synchronization, where right now the branch office is not connected to Tally.net server. We are just sending the masters from the head office level to branch level. Let us see to the branch level whether it has received or not. So from the gateway of Tally, we need to connect to Tally.net to see if there is any message for us. From the gateway of Tally, go to inventory information, stock item, and yes, we see all the three new items created are flown to Tally Mumbai office. So this was without passing of any transactions or any other methods of import of or export of masters. So this is directly from a master created in the head office level, which are flown to Mumbai to the branch office seamlessly. So let us also confirm one area where if any master has been altered at the head office level, so whether it has the same impact on the client side, so or on the branch side. So let us see that if we have altering any master, okay, say Tally Gold, we are making it as Tally Gold Edition. We write over here Tally Silver Edition. Okay, now let us send this and see what exactly happens at the branch side or the client side. So data has been sent from the head office. The altered masters have been sent from head office. So let's see what happens in the client side. So let us confirm. From gateway of Tally, we go to inventory information, stock items, and see whether the masters have been altered here also. Yes. Tally Gold has become Tally Gold Edition, and Tally Silver has become Tally Silver Edition. So we confirm here that even the
alteration of masters, it has been very well taken care in tally.erp 9 release 5.
So we see here, master data created at the head office will automatically sync with all branches. Whenever the head office creates masters for its respective branches. Therefore, a customer can now restrict master creation to only the head office and block this at the branch level and then keep syncing master created at the head office. This will prevent duplication and bring control across the organization. You will not find multiple ledger accounts for the same ledger. All reports will appear just the way the customer wants. And any changes made to masters at HO will also get synced. So the customer need not worry about making changes at the branch levels. This will give tremendous peace of mind to all users.
We turn our attention to delete transaction synchronization. With release 5.0, deleted vouchers can be synchronized just as cancelled transactions are synced. If a voucher is deleted at the branch offices, the corresponding effect will automatically be reflected in the central system. Neither will the synchronization rule break, and nor will the branch offices be required to create a rule for data synchronization. Let us see this in the action.
So now we take the first instance, first scenario where we had passed two sales transactions. Okay, this is the head office level, Tally Bangalore, and we had the same two transactions in the branch, Tally Mumbai. So here we are able to see two transactions have been passed. I mean, two transactions which we had received from head office. Now from here, we go to once again to the head office and delete one transaction. Okay, say XYZ trader. Okay, we delete this transaction. Okay, and let us synchronize from the head office to the branch office by pressing OOO. Let us check at the branch level. So let us see the transaction. Yes, we have only one transaction. XYZ traders transaction has been deleted from the branch office side also.
As shown in the demo, deletion of vouchers will get synced just like the cancelled vouchers. Because of this, data in the server will match data in the client exactly the same. The statistics of both the companies will remain same. No manual intervention is required to sync deletion of the transaction. Now, a customer can be assured that the data at all his locations will always match data at his head office.
Tally.erp 9 release 5.0 brings along with it a couple of reports for data synchronization. This particular report will show you the list of all the data synchronized along with the respective details. The sync rule used whether it is master or transaction, the date on which the sync has happened, the mode of synchronization whether online or on demand, the offline, and the sync status. Also, this is a second report that features the list of synchronization, the transactions that have failed along with the reason for failure. So let us see a few reports which are there for synchronization in Tally ERP 9 release 5.0. So from gateway of Tally we go into import of data synchronization. So here we have the reports, so transaction sync summary, status and exceptions. So this is the summary of all the transactions which have been synchronized. If there were any errors or any pending transactions which are there for synchronization,
will be shown in this area. Also, we have reports for status, like it tells us about the name of the rule which was synchronized, the last synchronized date with time, whether it was done successfully or not, and also the mode, means whether it was online or on demand. So these are the information which are available in sync status report. Also, we have exceptions. Now here in exceptions, it brings out if any transactions were not synchronized because some of the other reasons. So it will give you the transactions which are not synchronized with reasons. Now let us see, for example, in the client side, we create one transaction with zero entries. Say allow zero valued entries in transactions, and say we pass one sales transaction, a cash transaction, okay, without any value, and save, and then we synchronize from branch to head office. We had enabled F11 only at the branch level and not at the head office level. So let us see whether the data sent, the zero valued entry which was passed in branch, has been sent from there and whether it has been received by the head office or not. So we synchronize from the head office for that transaction. So let us see in the exception reports. So here we get the message that the transactions which has not moved from branch to head office had no entries in vouchers. So it will give you some information about like which transactions were not able to send or received from the either side. So this is one exception report which will help us to understand what exactly has happened because of any mismatch in the F11 or any other exception scenarios. So in a nutshell, Tally 5.0 have massively simplified the way data synchronization is done in Tally. Computers that sync need not be connected at the same time. With on-demand synchronization, computers that need not be connected at the same time. Efficient and seamless multi-point synchronization. As a result, customers now can enjoy multi-point synchronization efficiently and seamlessly, and that too without facing any performance issues. Data across locations can now be consolidated and disseminated with great ease. Master synchronization. The robust mechanism of master data synchronization brings along with a new business benefit like consistency and control in master creations. Also, changes or modifications made to masters will get synced automatically. Deleted transaction sync. With deleted transaction synchronization in place, no more manual intervention is required to sync deleted vouchers. They happen as simple as the cancelled vouchers. And also, the synchronization rules do not break because of this deletion of transactions. And finally, great reliability. All this ensures a high degree of data integrity and reliability across locations. This gives the power to make efficient and quick business decision. Isn't it? So let us come to the last part of the agenda, FAQs. How long will my data remain on Tally.net server? Data will be removed from Tally.net server once consumed. Any data that is not consumed will be removed after 7 days. Can I synchronize users, login and security rights? In 5.0, we are providing the most commonly used masters and transaction sync. As far as these advanced requirements are concerned, the same need to be analyzed and validated. Will the tax triangulation settings get synced? Yes, they will. Tally stores this internally in a format that ensures they also get synced. So, if a branch had triangulated a VAT report, for example, and synced with head office, the configuration will also be synced. Can I sync only for a period or up to some date? No. Sync will be for all the data in the company. How to restrict deletion of vouchers or masters? This need to be restricted from security control feature. The same is not possible through sync configuration. I want to control the sync of deleted vouchers. Synchronization of deleted vouchers is enabled by default. However, users can choose to disable it in the room. Can I sync between different base currencies? This was supported even in the earlier versions of Tally. Can I create multiple client rules for transaction sync? No. The system will allow users to create a single active rule. However, if a user tries to create a second rule, the system will give an error message. A rule already exists for the selected destination, cannot create duplicate rule. What will happen if masters are altered? If the option synchronized altered master is disabled, then duplicate masters will be created at the other end. Do I require to create new rule for masters, that is other than transaction? Yes, it is necessary to create new rules for master synchronization. Can I create masters at client and sync with head office? Yes. When defining rules, there's an option direction of sync in which we can select receive data or send data. Select the direction based on your requirement. Can I create separate rules for receive and send masters? No, it is not possible to create separate rules for receive and send master data. So hope you have got the clarity on the next generation synchronization in Tally.ERP 9 release 5.0. Thank you.